this, and he said, Brian, this is Dick, and he said, Dick, who? I was fading. Maybe he gave me a chance to hang up and then talk to me in the morning. And he said, Dick Gordon, and he said, what can I do for you, Brad? And he said to me, my people need your help. He didn't say, I need your help. He said, my people need your help. And I said, what's this all about? And he said, don't you recall the senators kicked out the U.S. bases? So what do we do? He said, we have to form and file a bill creating a free port. And I said, when are we going to meet? Next week? He said, no, in a few hours. So he told me to meet him in Annabelle's restaurant. And this is the first time when we met at Annabelle's that I met who was to be there, our future vice chairman, Babe Sigson. Babe, tumayo ka naman. You are much a part of this. Babe Sigson, the first vice chairman of the SPMA, former secretary of the DPWH, and now lately enjoying the private life, being hounded only by the PIR and no longer by other government agencies. And so it was, we met at Annabelle's, and there was a person, I won't mention his name, he wanted to turn Cubic Peg into a garment textile manufacturing firm. He wanted to put a garment manufacturing firm there. No vision whatsoever. And then Dick Gordon came up, Mayor Bolongapo, presented his plan. How many of you know that Dick Gordon came up with a plan for the Freeport as early as 1971? And in 1980, Dick Gordon put it in writing and submitted it to then President Ferdinand Marcos and then Defense Secretary Marcos in Brunei. And he said, this is going to be Subic one day, a Freeport like Hong Kong. And then Marcos told him, Brad, hindi aalis, the Americans are not going to leave. And Brilliant told him the same thing. And so when the Americans left, guess who the only one, the only person who had a real plan for Subic was Dick Gordon. And we boldly went to Congress after that meeting with that person, again I won't mention his name. Babe Sigson was sold on the idea, he supported us. We went to Congress and we lobbied. And Dick, first of all, we went to his house. You know the last thing I know was written in a 20 square meter room in his house in Longo City using Word Star 4 program. Wala pa kami nun. And I wasn't a tax lawyer at that time. Today I'm a tax lawyer. But he asked me, what should be the tax incentives we give to investors? And from out of the blue, I just kicked up 5% of gross income earned. It's a good thing we said gross income earned, because if it was 5% of gross revenues, there would be no investors here. Right, Tita Julie? Tita Julie used to be a BIR representative here. She was a district collector here. Now she's a member of the board. So, medyo original din si Tita Julie. She's an original here. So anyway, when we decided, they told me to bring the Freeport provisions of what is now Republic Act 7227. They told me to bring it to Senator Shahani, because at that time, the Senate was already in its second reading of the bill. And when I got to Senator Shahani, this is what she said. She said, it's too late, my son. If you want, you run for Congress and propose this. That's what she said. So I called up Dick Gordon. Congressman Hernandez knows the workings in Congress. He knows how difficult it is. But Dick Gordon is a man who doesn't say quit. He doesn't know the word quit. I called him up and I said, boss, the Brad, Shahani said, it's too late to introduce SPMA into the bill. What do you want me to do? He said, may I talk to Shahani? So she got the phone and gave it to her. And you know, I heard her say, yes, Dick. Okay, Dick. No problem, Dick. Correct, Dick. Okay. She hung up. And then she said to me, son, give me the proposed conditions. So I gave it to her. And you know what she said? You know what she said? We will introduce it. I went back to Dick Gordon and I asked him, what did you say to her that Jesus are coming soon. If you don't put this in the bill, you'll not only be zero in Olongapo, you'll be zero in the whole of Zambales. So he spoke to her in a language, she understood, and the rest is history. We introduced the bill, we lobbied in Congress. They brought the volunteers of Olongapo. You know, they brought their own lunch. All volunteers, victory liner. Ocholo Garian lent his victory liner to ferry the volunteers from Olongapo to lobby in the Senate. We were inside lobbying with the senators. We had an advocate in Congress, Kay Gordon, who was then the congresswoman for the first district of Zambales. And she lobbied there. We had it passed in Congress. And then we had it passed in the Senate. All because of the vision of Dick Gordon. I'm not trying to make Dick Gordon a god. I'm just trying to put things in perspective. This country needs vision. And without vision, you cannot have a future. Because if you're only thinking of your immediate needs, then it won't happen. Earlier there was a comment. Yes, it's true, we're not yet to Hong Kong. Yes, it's true, we're not yet to Singapore. But I will tell you, it's not because we lack effort here. Every step of the way we were in SPMA, people from other sectors of government were putting obstacles in our way. James knows this. This is not a local development. This is a national institution. The SPMA belongs to the entire Philippines. But those who are running it are from this area. And those who are running it have the heart to continue to run it. I am so proud to have been a part of this history. This is history. My name is also there in the volunteer shrine. And that's what I'm proud of. When I bring my kids, I point to them. Your father, just like Mercedes Washington, just like Chairperson Isma. And I thank the original volunteers. Please stand up and be recognized. Guys, Attorney Keanu Rio. Instead of investing in other places, to invest in Subic. Because I have an investment here. My heart is here. After Subic, I was asked by Senator Juan Ponce Vile to head up again Economic Zone Authority. And I was there also for 4.5 years. But I always find myself coming home. This is my second home. I think that I am a legitimate adopted son of Olongapo and Subic. And because of Subic and because of what we experienced here, this country will never be the same. This is the first free port in the country. Many others have followed suit. There's Cagayan, there's Aguada, now there's Clark. And you know, sino nagdagan ng Clark sa SPMA? Si Dick Gordon. Siya mismo nakaisip. In those days, Dick, the ideal of SPMA was Argo. Autonomous region of Greater Olongapo. That's what Dick wanted to pass before. But he said, it also stands for Attorney Richard Gordon of Olongapo. So I remember that time, he said, what do we name the SPMA? We were in that 20 square meter room, and I said, why not? I thought of the MMDA. Why don't we call it Subic Bay Metropolitan Authority? And he said, write it down. And then he called up Attorney Chico Veracruz of Accra Law Office. Dick and I, aside from being fraternity brothers in Upsilon, we are also from Accra Law Office. And we called up Attorney Chito Veracruz and we said, Chito, what is a free port? Dick knew, but I didn't, so I had to get his advice. Chito, what should we put in the law? And because of that conversation, you have what you have today, 7227. It has withstood the crucible of time, and it is now the model for other free ports. Unfortunately, there will be no more because I understand that the national policy is no longer to create free ports. Sayang, gusto sana ni Congressman Hernandez mayroon sa Cotabato. Sa San Cotabato. Pero di bale, he knows what to do there. Being a lawyer and a good legislator, we can always create one through PESA or the